Hello everyone, in this part 2 of probability, we will discuss about the addition theorems on probability. First of all, we will discuss a very important point, that is the complementary event. An event which occurs when the event A does not occur is known as the complementary event of E, and it is denoted by E dash or E bar. And probability of E plus probability of not happening a E, the sum of these two is always equals to 1. This is the very very important relation to solve the questions also. Now come to the addition theorems on probability. For this, let us suppose E, F and G are the events associated with a random experiment. Then on the basis of sets, we did one proof that the number of elements in A union B is equals to number of elements in A plus number of elements in B minus number of elements in A intersection B. There is a rule in probability also that the probability of E union F is equals to probability of E plus probability of F minus probability of E intersection F. And in this part, if E and F are mutually exclusive, what is this? These events are mutually exclusive events. Then for this we have E intersection F is always equals to phi. It means the probability of E intersection phi F is equals to 0. Therefore, this rule is converted into probability of E union F must be equals to probability of E plus probability of F. So this is the another rule, which one we will obtain on the basis of this if the events are the mutually exclusive. Now the another theorem, probability of E union F union G is equals to probability of E plus probability of F plus probability of G minus probability of E intersection F minus probability of F intersection G minus probability of G intersection E plus probability of E intersection F intersection G. Now there are another theorems which we have to remember because we have to use this theorem in questions. What is this? Probability of E intersection F dash is equals to probability of E minus probability of E intersection F. In the same way, probability of E dash intersection F is equals to probability of F minus probability of E intersection F. And on the basis of De Morgan's law, probability of E dash intersection F dash is always equals to probability of E union F dash is equals to 1 minus probability of E union F. And probability of E dash union F dash is equals to probability of E intersection F dash is equals to 1 minus probability of E intersection F. So these rules are very very important to solve the questions also. Let's do some questions. Look at this thing. In question number 1, we have probability of E union F is equals to 0.6, probability of E intersection F is equals to 0.3, and we have to obtain the probability of E dash plus probability of F dash. Now you will say, because as we know that probability of E union F is always equals to probability of E plus probability of F minus probability of E intersection F, and probability of E union F is already 0.6, we can write down probability of E is equals to 1 minus probability of E dash plus, in the same way, 1 minus probability of F dash, and this is already given 0.3. It means this becomes 0.9, and this is 2 minus probability of E dash plus probability of F dash. Sorry, this is minus only. Now shift these two terms here. It means probability of E dash plus probability of F dash is equals to 2 minus 0.99. 0.9 means 1.1. So this is the way to solve the questions by using these theorems. Now look at this thing. There is another question. in this question we have given that events E and F are such that probability of E is equals to half. It means probability of E is equals to 1 by 2. Probability of E in union F is equals to 3 upon 5. And probability of F is equals to P. We have to find out P if E and F are mutually exclusive. You will say because E and F are mutually exclusive, therefore mutually exclusive events, therefore we have E intersection F is equals to phi. It means the probability of E intersection F is equals to 0. Now because we know that probability of E union F is equals to probability of E plus probability of F minus probability of E intersection F. Now probability of E union F, we have already 3 upon 5 and this is 1 upon 2 and this is plus P minus 0 because this is from equation 1. So let us consider this is the equation 1 and we will mention here this is from equation 1. It means P is equals to 3 upon 5 minus 1 upon 2. What is the LCM? 10 is the LCM. 5 to the 10, it means 6. 2 5 to it means 10. It means this become 1 upon 10. And this is the answer. Now the C part for this. If E and F are two events such that probability of E intersection F is equals to 1 upon 8, find the probability of E dash union F dash. Now probability of E dash union F dash is always equals to, what is this? Probability of E intersection F whole dash, and this is equals to 1 minus probability of E intersection F. Now 1 minus, what this become? 1 upon 8. It means the answer for this one is 7 upon 8. So these are the very very important rules which we will use to solve the questions. So do the practice related to this type of questions and don't forget to give the answer of this question in comment box. Thanks and God bless you.